Hello, friends from Budafe, how are you? I'm hoping you are doing well. I'm Victor Lars, and it's my pleasure to be with you today. Before everything, I want to give all the Budafe team thanks for trusting me on this incredible adventure, and as you may imagine, I'm extremely happy. And of course, I have to give everyone thanks, because without you, this couldn't be possible. So, at first, I want to give thanks, and also ask you, as always, to be a little patient with me, because believe it or not, the most comfortable I am is always shooting, always taking pictures, and being in front of a camera or being on a stage, believe me, it's always something new for me, and always makes my heart pumps, almost as I'm in a wedding. On today's video, I would like to talk about how to take or capture incredible wedding images, or what is the same, how to convert something normal into something extraordinary, how to get incredible images or interesting images on places that apparently have no photographic interest. In the next minutes, I will talk a little about all that, and also I'll show you some videos where you can see me working, so you may see the before and after. As you may see, I'm not very good at words. Well, thanks to the photographs, I will make it a little better. Well, before we begin talking about how to take incredible or interesting wedding images, we have to start talking about who we are as photographers. What is our project as photographers? I mean, for example, if right now our partner or family or anyone, or we like to do a personal project, before we start you know, these jobs, what kind of photographers are you? I mean, have you stopped thinking which hour would you prefer to take the pictures? I mean, would you go out and down to make the photographs with your partner or your personal project? Or will you go with the sunset? Or maybe at noontime? Or maybe on the afternoon? What I mean is, it's super important to be honest with you as photographers, and all that and all the elements or the projects that you have as photographers, take it to the wedding world. Definitely, at the moment that you... I mean, the moment where you are the same photographers in a personal project and the same photographer when you're doing a wedding or something like this kind of jobs, at the time when things are going to begin to function well. And for that, we have to understand what kind of light is the light that we are more comfortable, what kind of elements would you like to use so our photographs may highlight or maybe not, but how are you comfortable with ourselves? What kind of element do you like to photograph for anything? For example, in my case, I love the geometry, as you may see, a lot of times. And also, if you photograph your partner, what kind of corporal language are you using in your pictures? And at last, what kind of concept would you like to transmit? What is the meaning of the image that you are going to transmit or you're going to take? In my personal case, I love that in my images are not finished. The spectator, when I'm watching some of my pictures, have different point of view, or maybe thinks there's something's happening, and different spectator thinks a different thing. They are open to the interpretation of the betrayal. And that's what I'm trying to look in each one of the pictures that I'm making. Right now, I'm talking about different terms, really important. One is the light, the other is geometry, and the other is the corporal language. You may see that these three points are like the bone structure of all my photography. And I'm meaning photography. I'm not really talking about wedding photography. But these three elements, light, geometry, and corporal language, is that I like to translate always the wedding photography. If you're talking about light, the first point that we have to start, the engine of all photography, or my photography, and of course, all photography. I mean, I have to say, the light where I'll feel more comfortable is like a hard light, or like some interesting light. What I'm trying to say here is that powerful and hard light, that interesting light, I may be twice as direct, I may be a lot of more dramatic, and also more abstract. I mean, thanks to the hard light, I may give potential to some areas of my pictures, or may not show some parts, and that makes a lot of easy play with a multitude of aspects, and of course get results really interesting. I mean, thanks to the light, always you may see everything. And always I used to start all my videos talking about light. I know a lot of you may think, oh my god, but I already know this. But have you really stopped and think for a second what kind of light is your light? What's your favorite of all kind of lights? This is the point of beginning. I'd like to talk to you about what is geometry. And geometry is something that is super important in all my pictures. And let's say, like in a really, really easy way, is that I'm always trying to find geometric lines. When I say geometric lines, referring to circles, or maybe squares, or maybe triangles, all that concept of stuff always attracts me a lot, and I'm always looking like crazy finding it. A triangle of light, a circle, a rectangle. Any of these elements will help me to find the kind of photograph that I'm looking for. Of course, I will talk about circles, and I would like to introduce to you these pictures that you're seeing right now. So maybe I can explain a little how did I get this concept and how I finally executed it. Of course, think about this. We're talking about a circle that is painted on the wall, as you like something weird. Maybe we don't really, or I didn't really understand why in that place, on that restaurant, had a circle on a wall. But I thought, how may I play with the couple and how to grab something from there? Of course, when I start working with a couple, don't you think that from an idea or a concept like a circle, it's going to get out a brilliant idea? And that's it. There's a really good picture there. It's something like little by little, putting the couple in separate ways, out of the circle, start playing with them, and then that maybe the strong part may be putting the couple in the center in a different perspective, so the bride is closer to me, so they gain a little volume, and the groom at the bottom, and then definitely play, and then the bride get this way, and the groom the other way, and what I try to get, they both look like they are part of the same being, like the boy getting out of the girl, and the girl getting out of the boy, okay? So, as I'm telling you, the geometric lines help me on a big way and make part of my project as a photographer, and of course in the weddings. But also I want to introduce to you something that is really important. Same as a lot of my pictures are really complex images, and I like to play with the complexity of the picture, I like to be the most plain as possible, and the most minimalist possible. And in the case when I'm trying to organize a portrait, something that always tends to get clean backgrounds that help me to realize the subject, you know? We'll see, for example, where you may see that the boys, apparently you see like they are like climbing or going up like two ramps, like it's a triangle, but look as the background is perfectly clean. But I like to show you the location previous to the shoot of this picture. The images I'm showing you, just you see Erica, and was take the day previous of the wedding. You see? There's no wedding that if we don't know the location or don't know the place where they're getting married or the restaurant or whatever, the previous day of the wedding, you have to visit it. Not for know what kind of light you were going to have, but because you know maybe a sunny day or tomorrow maybe a cloudy day. But it's like knowing a little how is the space distributed, what is the perspective with the human being. So the day of the wedding, well, you will have some march to experiment and maybe do some crazy things. But of course, we're gonna have a script as you told you. The previous day, we got some pictures, like checking the place, and Erica, when was taking notes just on the place you're seeing, that's when I thought, when I'm taking some pictures of Erica here, it's like a postal, where you may see the mountains, the river. Of course, that's not the project that I have as a photographer. There's nothing wrong with that. If you love that, take pictures, for example, or maybe to live there, the river and the mountains. But look that in my case, it's just the opposite. I love to clean everything. And that's why to play with the deformity that the 35 millimeters will give me, instead of shooting at eye level, I got to the floor and I forced that the lines, that triangular shape, and simply I asked the couple that the walk from the center to the extremes. That was the result, well, that the final result that we finally got. As you may see, and this way, I'm introducing you that how things go from all the geometric lines, how we're working on it, and always looking for them at every time. And now it's time to talk about the corporal or body language. And of course, the truth is that photographers play with a little disadvantage in front of videographers, and quotation marks, in the way that for a videographer, it may look easy that you say to the couple, say I love you to her, or say I love you to him, or whatever. Maybe we may listen to that, but on a photograph, there's no audio that we can listen. So we have to play with the body language, so we can tell to the spectator, introduce the spectator, that what is really going on there. And I always says that there's several points in the body language that are really, really important. The first one is the lips, the eyes, of course. And the most important I would like to really talk today is these things, hands. The hands have a really important and incredible information. And depending on how we play with them, they're going to give you a meaning or another. Things that if you see me begin the video with my hands on my pockets, what message I'm giving to? The message I'm giving is that I'm nervous, even though that I'm really, really nervous right now. For example, if you see me shaking or a fist, I mean, a hand, depending on how we play with it, is going to transmit a meaning or another, which I'm going to potentiate or give the most of my energy, isn't that worry about which or what concept we'll like to transmit with the hands. That's why in my pictures, you will always see some hands that do like this or do that. If I ask a couple that they get together or maybe kiss, I will always ask them that play with their hands, that she puts her hands on his chest or maybe play with the neck or the shoulder, I mean, whatever necessary to create that connection between them. I would like to stop and in the image, this picture you're watching. It's a real simple picture. As you may see, there's a triangle of light, an incredible shadow. And watch then on the top, both hands almost touching themselves. Look that for me, that's the meaning. Like a couple that is on the verge of getting together. In this picture, you may see all that I'm looking for. You see light, I elect the 6 o'clock in the afternoon. In summer, where's a lot of sun, but not as much as a noontime light, but the hard light. And look how, thanks to the light, I tried to find a geometric line. Things that a couple of minutes ago, I was talking about all this, that if you don't have a geometric shape or something like evidently close to me, I will try to find it. How? In this case, thanks to the light, I find a virtual triangle. But look, getting again to the hands, how important they are. And look, as I told you at the beginning, that I like that the spectator imagine things, that what's really going on. And what I like to transmit is that the pictures have more than one concept. The spectators participate. Maybe you can imagine one thing, and maybe another person imagine something different. The spectator may imagine that the couple that you're watching right now is almost there, something happened to them, and that's why they're not touching themselves. Definitely, you see, as the hands have an enormous power, and that's what I would like to tell you today. So these are the 3 points, principally, on this video, so we may understand or maybe explain what kind of photographer I am, and I will try to transmit that to what is the wedding pictures that I take. As I said at the beginning, be honest with yourself and the pictures that you're doing, for example, your partner or maybe your pet, and then that you translate that to the wedding photography, I'm sure things are going to begin to change. Of course, if you make mistakes like me when I started taking pictures there in 2010, that my biggest mistake was to think which are the most popular photographers on my city. That was A, B, and C. And the first thing I did was, well, let's begin to copy that. That was the truth. Instead of thinking, okay, who I am as photographer, what have I done in the previous years? I had worked 9 years as a journalist. Why didn't I think, extrapolate all that, all my knowledge, that all my press years, to what is the wedding world? Of course, the simplest thing was for me, what do they do, A, B, and C, what do they do? And then they did that kind of images. And what think, well, if they're doing well, doing that kind of images, maybe I can do that. If to be a wedding photographer I have to do this, I will do it the same. Without thinking for a second that what kind of photographer I am, what kind of concept I like to transmit, what kind of light I would like to transmit, do I like the composition or the geometric lines? Who was I as a photographer? That's why I didn't even think about it. And I get the easy way, and let me assure you that I almost fall down. That is really, really important, and maybe is the beginning point that you may think all photographers must do that. So then, when we begin with the wedding photography, it is an essence. So, my friends, this is it for today. I hope you like this. I hope I did it the best I can. You see, as you may see, I'm better taking pictures than talking in front of a camera. And you have to take in account that having a camera in front of me without people that blink or laugh or maybe whistle something is hard. But I thank you for your patience, and we'll see again really, really soon. I hope sooner or later we may begin to talk. I hope soon we can hug each other and have unforgettable moments like in Congress Boda Efe. So, my friends, see you on the next time and be good.